It's important to note that the first 12 months are crucial in the development of the heifer system. 75% of the frame growth occurs by 12 months of age, so we must get that stage right. Here on the Larkins farm, a lot of attention to detail has been paid to that, both by grassland management practices for the heifers and also management in the shed in the winter.
I think we have the finest bunch of heifers that we ever had. We weighed them earlier on there and they were up more than we expected of the gal weight.
The Larkin's attention to detail continues when the heifer goes to grass. They've implemented a rotational grazing system similar to the milking cows, where excess grass is conserved and taken out for bales to maintain grass quality. This way, heifer growth continues at grass right through to housing.
We've done a paddock system for the heifers as well, similar to cows. If a paddock got too strong, we cut it out. Well, we didn't run out of grass, even though we had a dry summer, and we kept grass ahead of the heifers all the time.
One tool that the Larkins have found useful in the springtime with calves going to grass to maintain rumen function is VistaCell Live Yeast. We're trying to develop the rumen bug population every day in the young calf. With VistaCell, we're adding millions of bugs to the rumen to encourage the growth of other bugs. This is key in helping the calf to adapt to the grass quickly. The Larkins further continue that momentum by maintaining the quality of the grass with the rotational grazing system. At housing then, the challenge changes. We need to adapt the weanling to grass silage perhaps for the first time. Again, the Larkins employ the use of VistaCell to help that transition phase into the shed. Instead of it taking 3 weeks for the weanling heifer to adapt to silage, normally on this farm the heifers are settled into the shed in 3 or 4 days. Once the heifers are settled into the shed, there's two key things that we focus on to maintain consistent growth. One is energy, the second is protein. To monitor energy, we look at body condition. Adjust a nice cover condition on the ribs, not too much, so that she's rounding off, or not too little that the ribs are exposed. We use energy to control this. Secondly, we look at the dung to give us an indication of how the levels of protein are. Too dry, we need a bit more protein. Too loose, and we possibly have an excess of protein or some other issue. As we said, the goal of the Larkins here is to incorporate a huge amount of home-produced feeds. One type of feed that is purchased is the protein. This is a key part of the heifer diet in the winter time. We incorporate moist feed, which achieves a few goals. Firstly, it promotes intakes from the beginning. The palatability of the moist feed in the ration means that heifers achieve dry matter intake goals very quickly once into the shed. Secondly, that protein helps the development of the frame growth, and as we said, we need to get 75% of that growth done in the first 12 months.
They're getting straw silage, moist feed, Trapper Gold, and a bit of soya and a small bit of beet there as well, and mineral.
The other thing that moist feed does in the ration is reduce sorting. This helps reduce competition between a bunch of heifers. This means that if we look at the weight difference of heifers going into the shed versus coming out of the shed, can be less a lot of the time when we've incorporated moist feed into the ration. At Specialist Nutrition, we pay particular attention to the heifer growth stage in order to realise the potential of each farm on a case-by-case basis.
We're not doing anything different to anybody, but we're doing a whole lot of little things, and the little things all add up.